We need to provide whatever logistics, whatever financial and whatever other assistance we can to any peacekeeping force that must be formed in order for us to have some kind of real effective force on the ground. I would suggest to you that if the Chinese continue to help the government of Sudan and continue to block our efforts in the United Nations, that we join a League of Democracies, a League of Democracies that value human rights, that never want to see this genocide take place again. And we act together. And if the Chinese and or the Russians or other autocratic nations don't wish to join us, that's fine. A League of Democracies would be committed to the common values and principles that we hold here, hold dear, about the fact that we believe that all men and women everywhere are endowed with certain inalienable rights. Those rights now in Darfur are being completely destroyed and trampled on. I don't know how you negotiate with the president of Sudan. Obviously, he has broken agreements. He has lied. He has encouraged and, in fact, equipped many of these Janjaweeds, terrorist organization. Our values are our security. And our values have to be maintained, otherwise our nation's security is in danger. I believe that America has the obligation to lead, to act, and I am gratified by organizations all over America, young people all over America, who have acted to goad our government and other governments to act to stop this genocide. I want to thank all of those people and organizations who have dedicated so much of their time, their effort, their energy, and their funds on behalf of people they've never known and never will know, but are suffering the most horrific situation today. And I believe that over time, with this kind of support and this kind of effort, that we will end the genocide in Darfur. Make your elected representatives know that how involved and engaged they are in this issue will determine who you support or not support.